of a weird this season because you're more split up than in previous seasons and you don't get to work with your group, or do they come back together?
There were times where I would call up the writers and be like, can I have more scenes with this character, please? I miss them. But it was great because I've got to work with people that I didn't work with as much in the first two seasons. I work a lot with Corey this season, so that was really fantastic. But it's been a great sort of mix-up of the storylines. I think that really helped us the doctor.
Yeah.
Anymore between you two?
That's
you
the best answer I have ever heard you give. It's amazing.
Any more between you two? You two had one of the best episodes of last season. Very.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Now, the thing is that you, at a certain point, if you have a structure that imposes itself, like you used to have a lot of scene with Prama, or you used to have a lot of scene with Fett, at a certain point you have to break it just to make it sexy again, because you can't wait until it becomes unsexy. You have to stop it when it's sexy, you know. You certainly won't see another pineapple scene between Dutch and Eichhorst in season 3, because the thing is done. So you have to find the next level of it, and you'll have the next level of that, but in a very surprising way, perhaps not extended over five episodes, you know. And the same thing happens with how you get confident with, you know. He just said he's much more with that. I'll have the relationship with Palmer turning sour and sourer. I have an assistant I work with, you know, so bringing new people in makes a thing produce new ways to go, you know.
We've heard it described as season 3 as the best yet. Do you feel that, and why? How has it topped the other two?
It's so epic. I felt, in actor terms, I felt like they had spent a lot more money because they were walking onto sets, and they've always been incredible, but it was like a blockbuster movie every day. It was hugely ambitious and wonderful, and everything's just amped up because we're still in New York, so you have to, in order to keep the story moving, you have to create more tension and stakes must be higher. So this season really barrels through at a pace.
It's a little bit like you're like the Statue of Liberty. Have you seen the Statue of Liberty and Tom coming out? Not even only talking about the thing that is in front of the hotel, I'm talking about the teaser you saw on the internet. I was so impressed by it, and then I remembered that's actually what I experienced the whole season through when I went in the middle of the night, beginning of my working time, when I went on set. I don't know how many times I went on set and I was just like that, what they prepared in terms of set, special effects, or just, and you were on a really fucking big blockbuster movie, and you were going to tell the story of the end of humanity, you know? And that you are given means to be impressed yourself, even though you're one of the leads. I'm the bad guy, I'm supposed to know what happens. I come here and like a kid. And that's a very, very, very good motivator to give it all in, to be ready to go for 16 hours. I actually broke my record. I've done nearly 100 movies, and I went through a lot of hard times. But this one is, what was my longest time on set? It was 21 hours.
Wow.
And you don't complain, because you know they don't do it in order to fuck you up. They do it because they know they need to. They have to grab the set or whatever. So, and you go with it. And if you are tempted to complain, you just have a look on your older comrades like David Bradley, and he gives you a lesson of humility. So there, in whatever situation you are inspired, supported. We hang out together. We actually have a lot of time, off time. We have a lot of dinner together, even breakfast, lunch. We're really a group, much closer than on any other side. I can remember.